Well, I think our guys were excited for the break. You know, the first half, there were some ups and downs, some challenges. I think we were in need of a break, you know, I think coming through exams. So I don't think that's ever a negative. You know, I think the rest, both from a mental standpoint as well as a physical standpoint, is a good thing. Just to see their enthusiasm when they got back, I think they missed being around each other. They missed playing and practicing. So it was a great, you know, we've had great practices so far. And I think they're just excited to get back out there. And, you know, it's a great way for us to get back by playing in our own tournament. You know, I mean, it's something we're very proud of. TD Bank and Sheraton do a great job sponsoring this event. And we've got a great field of teams, some different teams that our fans are not going to be used to seeing, but I think that adds flavor to the tournament. So we're for us, it's just trying to continue to worry about ourselves and what we have to do to have success. And we made some strides towards the end of the break, and we want to try to carry that into the new year, obviously.
Well, I mean, we basically only missed one weekend, so I mean, I don't think it's like you can blame it on a long break that we're not going to be able to keep that momentum. I think the big thing in this week right now is just kind of focusing on keeping doing the same things that we have. So, I mean, I don't think it's too big of a task, but you know, it's certainly something we got to focus on.
I think the break was good. To get the first half of the season, really, we're trying to find our identity there. I think we've tried to, tighten up the little spots where we had to. But I think we found our identity, and to come back here and have a good second half.
I think they can survive as an independent, but obviously if they could join a conference, that'd be best for the interest of Alabama-Huntsville. That being said, they've had some big wins this year. You look at their record, might not be indicative of what they've accomplished. You know, they knocked off Notre Dame when Notre Dame was number one in the country. I think a lot of their losses have come at 2-1, 3-1. They're a great goaltender. He's played, if you look at his statistics, for a team that's 4-9-1, to have a goaltender that has above 92 save percentage and I think under 2.5 goals against average says a lot about him and their team in terms of their team defense. So we'll have our work cut out for us.
To be honest, I mean, I know very little about the teams coming in. I think Duluth is ranked close to the top 10, but besides that, I don't really know. As Coach Sneddon kind of preaches, we focus on what we're doing and stuff like that. So they can bring what they want, but, we'll be thinking about what we got.
Mercyhurst, if you're looking at it, is probably the hottest team coming into the tournament. You know, I think they struggled in their non-conference games early on, but have since gone, I think, 9 games unbeaten. So they're playing extremely well. They've got Rick Ockett's done a great job. Talk about a team that plays great offensively. You know, if you look, I think they have 4 or 5 guys that are over a point a game. They do a very good job, and their team obviously went to the championship game last year in their conference and return, I think, all of their 5 top scorers. So they'll be a very good team, and certainly will give Minnesota-Duluth, who's also an excellent team, a very good run for their money. So it'll be great for our fans. I mean, it's, you've got Alabama who's going to come in here and trying to prove something, and, you've got Mercyhurst who's on a roll, and they're obviously, trying to enhance their, postseason chances, and Minnesota-Duluth who's, in the top 12 power rating right now. So it's a great field of teams, and we're looking forward to it.